Hello everyone. So hello and welcome everyone at Sona Mantra. And we will study today very important and hot topic FTS, that is first trimester screening. And first trimester screening is very important. These days FTS is not limited only to nasal bone, that is NB, and anti-nuchal translucency. It is much beyond than that, and it is as important as anomaly scan of 18 to 22 weeks. Now let's see how we can do and how we can do FTS. So let's start. What we have to look in FTS systematically. So divide your scanning into two parts. Let's see. So that is sagittal scanning, or sweep, and transverse sweep. So in sagittal scanning, try to look from head to toe like this. In the head, try to see whether skull bone is present or not. Like this. This is part of the skull bone. Skull bone is present or not. If it is absent, then it is taken. If it is present or not, and so that we can rule out anencephaly and acrania. Then after this, what should come? Fetal position. That is, fetal position should be flexed. And if the fetus is showing deflexed position, that is stargazing appearance, then that may be a case of anencephaly. So always look for fetal position. In fetal position, fetus position should be flexed. Okay. Now, after that, there comes to nasal bone. If nasal bone, then look for nasal bone. In the nasal bone, try to appreciate equal sign or better the continuity of the nasal bone. Zoom the images and try to see the continuity of the nasal bone just after the ending of the frontal bone ends here, and the nasal bone starts, and this is the nasal bone. So always try to appreciate. This is much better than equal to sign. This is, try to see ending of the frontal bone, and after that you should see echogenic line, and that is nasal bone. Now what other we can see in the other sagittal, this is palate, and this is mandible. And after that, after the nasal bone, we have to look for nasal nuchal translucency. Now nuchal translucency, in first trimester, 2 points more on nasal bone. In first trimester, presence of nasal bone is enough. That is, its major bone is enough. That is, if a nasal bone is present, then its size is of not much value. If nasal bone is present, then whether nasal bone is present or not, we have to label this. And if it is present, then if nasal bone is absent or small, you can follow it after 2-3 weeks, that is up to 15 weeks or later. After a nasal bone, look for NT, that is nuchal translucency. And normally it should be less than 2.5 mm. And if greater than 2.5 mm, 2.5 mm, then it falls in abnormal categories, and it is to be followed up with screening test. So anti-scanning and measurement is also a complete topic, and I will send details of the same, how to measure anti-nuchal translucency. In short, magnification of the image should be done such that fetal head and thorax occupy the whole of the screen, just like that. Fetal head and thorax should occupy whole of the screen, and you have to measure from inner border to inner border, like this, inner border to inner border, like this. And after inner border to inner border, in short, magnification of the image should be done, that is the fetal head and thorax should occupy the whole of the screen, and measure from anechoic area, inner to inner border, and care must be taken not to distinguish between fetal skin and amnion. If it is not clear, then shake with prop and wait for fetal movement, like this. I'm showing like this. This is, wait. This is fetal skin, and this is fetal skin and this is amnion. This is amnion. And you have to zoom in this picture, zoom and measure this anechoic area, and not this one. Now, after anti, look for any neck anomaly. Okay, let's see. We have covered up head and face. Now we will look any neck lesions, like rule out any neck lesion like cystic, any neck lesion like lymphatic collection called cystic hygroma ETC. If any neck lesion is present, then look for generalized edema too. Now after neck, it comes to chest. After neck, it comes to chest, and look for homogeneous ecotexture lungs like this. And in the chest, we can also rule out if there is any ectopic cardia is present or not. So, ectopic cardiac is present or not. Then it comes to abdomen. In abdomen, look for abdominal wall continuity, and rule out gastrochisis and omphalocele. Now here, never confuse or have doubt between normal physiological gut herniation and omphalocele and gastrochisis, as physiological gut herniation usually subsides by 12 to 13 weeks. If it present after 13 weeks and liver is present, then it is abnormal. After abdomen, we have to look for continuity of the spine. This is the spine continuity. Look and always look for the continuity of the spine. Okay. Continuity of the spine. And after any, look for any, and abnormal spinal curvature and also look for any other whether spinal curvature is normal or not and rule out any spinal deformity. And in the last, after that, in the abdomen, we have to look for any large cystic lesion in urinary bladder. That is megacystitis. If bladder diameter greater than 7 mm in first trimester, then it is fetal megacystis. And it is to be followed with screening and size. After spine, look for any limb deformity and in both upper limbs and lower limbs. Okay. Any limb deformity in upper limb and lower limbs. We can rule out any limb deformity, any fused limbs or absent digits. We can also make out at this time. Okay. Now this was sagittal scanning. Now, after that, in the beginning, after sagittal scanning, let's come to transverse or axial scanning. Again, start from the head to toe. Yes. Again, head to start from the head to toe. In the head, always look for almost complete filling of the ventricles by the choroids. That is, and giving beautiful butterfly appearance. This is called butterfly appearance. Choroid almost completely filling the ventricles. Okay. Now, after that, in the transverse sweep, we can rule out comes to limbs, upper limbs. See how clearly we can see humerus, both radius ulna and thumb and the digits in upper limb. Both limbs we can make out. How clearly we can make out in both. This is one and this is second. Yes. Also, in the same after head, we can see both the eyes also. See how clearly we can see both the lenses. Once again, let me show you. And we can make out the continuity of the lips. And we can make out the cleft lip in first trimester also. This is better appreciation of the both eye sockets with eye lens, and this is continuity of the lip. And similarly, we can see in the lower limb we can see again, see, this is femur. This is femur, both femur and dixie, both tibia and both two lines parallel, both tibia and fibula. And after that we can see feet. Both feet can be, yes, both tibia and fibula, yes. And we have to look up, cover up to both feet. Both feet. Both feet, yes. So till now we have covered almost every part except heart. Now let's see how to visualize heart. See, I try to appreciate try to appreciate four chambers, 1, 2, 3, 4, with convex probe and zooming the image, we are zooming the image, four chamber of the heart. Let's see in cine. Yes, we can appreciate the four chambers of the heart. After that you can make out stomach also. Now till now we have scanned the fetus with convex probe only. Now the second trip in FTS is always try to scan with linear probe also. Whenever in doubt and whenever you want to see clarify something, many things, you should try with linear probe and see the difference. There is a remarkable difference with linear probe. Let me show you that also. Okay, this was the scanning with, now this is the scanning with, now this is the scanning with linear probe. So always try to appreciate whenever you are in doubt in with convex probe, always try to see with linear probe also. Okay, then let's see how is the difference. This is the nasal bone. See how clearly we can see now. Of the continuity with the ending of the frontal bone, this is nasal bone. Okay, let me show you one more video. Okay, let's see on the next, another video. Okay. See the difference. How clearly we can see limbs, both upper limb, both humerus, both tibia and both radius and ulna, and thumbs and finger digits in upper limb. And see how clearly we can see nasal bone in this. Yes, this is nasal bone. This is nasal bone. Just when the ending of the frontal bone, this is nasal bone. And this is palate and this is mandible. See how clearly we can visualize. This is one humerus, this is radius and ulna, and how clearly we can see each digit, thumb and each digit with linear probe. This is one more. See how clearly both radius and ulna, and see how clearly we can see both limbs, and each bone, each digit and thumb, we can clearly make out much better with linear probe. Now see few more images with linear probe. See how better we can differentiate the echogenicity of chest, heart, diaphragm. How clearly we can see, make out diaphragm, and also spine looks so beautifully with linear probe. Also the continuity of the abdominal wall we can make out clearly with linear probe, and ruling out any physiological gut herniation, omphalocele gastroschisis also. And one more. This is again sagittal scanning with linear probe. Now we will see transverse sweep with linear probe. See how clearly we can make out things here. Now again, this is head. In the head we see beautiful choroid filling almost completely the ventricles, both ventricles. and after that, see how beautifully we can see both eyes, lenses, one, two, and how again both, in both upper limbs, both humerus is radius ulna, thumb and each digit of upper limb we can clearly see in this. And also in this view we can see also continuity in upper lip, yes, we can see. Yes, we can see continuity of the upper lip and rule out cleft lip also. Yes. So again, and one more video with them. Yes, much more better appreciation of the upper limb bones and each digit thumb clearly with linear probe. And see how clearly now comes to heart. See how clearly we can see chambers, crux, both chambers. Okay, that is. So let me show you again. Four chambers of the heart, crux, and also see how beautifully we can see transfer three vessels. This is pulmonary artery. This is pulmonary artery. Now, yeah, this is pulmonary artery. This is pulmonary artery. We can appreciate even this is pulmonary artery. Three vessel view in first trimester with linear probe. This is one part. After that, now comes to see also this how bad, how good. We can see both lower limbs. This is one femur. This both tibia, both tibia and fibula. See how clearly we can see both the both lower one. Yes, both lower limb. All the lower limb bones, femur, both tibia and fibula, and yes, both tibia and fibula, any foot abnormality, and also CTV, we can rule out any foot deformity, CTV at this stage also. Now, after that, we come to in the last, come to heart with color. This is linear scanning with color. See, normal color. See how better. See how to appreciate. These are four chambers, and we can see. Yes, this is the filling of the both ventricles. Filling of the ventricles appreciated with color. This is. And after, and this is three vessel view, and this is pulmonary artery. This is pulmonary artery on linear scan with color. See, try to appreciate much better with cine. Yes, we are seeing filling of the four chambers with color and three vessel. Yes. This is pulmonary artery in blue. pulmonary artery in blue. And when that, and the one more, this was with normal, this was with normal color, normal color, and now see difference with power Doppler. This is with power Doppler. See how more, how beautifully we can appreciate the heart chamber filling and heart chamber filling and the pulmonary artery. Let me show you again. This is the, these are the chambers. These are the chamber filling, yes. And this is pulmonary. This is pulmonary artery. This is pulmonary artery. This is pulmonary artery. So this was all about scanning of the first trimester with both convex and linear probes. And you have seen there is difference between convex and linear probe. So always try to see with linear probe also. And again, when also when the fetus is in low lying and there is difficulty in scanning with linear probe, then you can try with TVS2. TVS also produces good images, and we can see much better clear picture on TVS. So two sweeps. So good FT screening and of the head and body and limbs with good CRL and biometry will pretty much exclude these anomalies. Scan systematically, zoom the images on the screen as baby is small and we need to see it all clearly. In the last, also try to look for chambers of the heart. So difficult in the beginning, but with routine practice and daily you can see that too. Now it's clear to all what we have to look in FTS. Whenever you have doubt with convex probe, try immediately with linear probe as there is remarkable difference you have seen. It will make your imaging more clear and so will be the diagnosis. If the fetal position is low lying, then you can try for TVS also. Now I am setting you one example of the importance of probe selection. Last year an obese patient was there about and pregnancy was about 12 weeks. When I was scanning, I couldn't see the fetal head clearly. So done TVS for confirmation, and it was a case of anencephaly. So I gave the diagnosis of the anencephaly. Next day the patient and his attendants were in doubt, and they went to other center, and that doctor gave them normal report. Then they were in doubt, they came to me again and showed me the report. Then as a routine habit of storing abnormal videos, I sent the stored image of that case to that doctor, and he immediately said that it's in anencephaly. But then I said, why should you give normal report? He said that I have done only transabdominally and not TVS, and you have done TVS. Then I said, it is the doctor who decides whether we should go for TVS or not, and not the patient. Anyhow, the doctor corrected his report, and the patient was counseled accordingly and undergone abortion. Now this is to show you the importance of probe selection. We should be never in hurry, and we should always try to look with both probe, convex, linear, and TVS, by all probes. So in the last tips and tricks of FTS is, first of all, probe selection: convex, linear, TVS. Go for one by one if you think. Now second is fetus position. If fetus is not in proper position, then
If it not in proper sagittal position with spine down and face up, then wait for same and rescan the patient after some time. As always, try to scan in proper fetal position as shown in the videos. Third, zoom the images, that is magnify the image for proper measurement and proper clarity. Fourth, follow the protocol as described in the video. Fifth, practice and never wait for proper indication. That is, whenever you scan any pregnant female in first trimester, always try to see nasal bone, nasal nuchal translucency, intracranial translucency and all the above anomalies we have discussed today. So make it a habit and routine to see all the anomalies every time you scan a patient during this time. Problem is that people are not in habit of seeing everything in every patient. The day you start seeing all the anomalies in all the patient, more than problem is solved. So try with proper technique and magnification. You will face less problem and less strain in diagnosing the abnormal ones. Mind you, abnormal is very easy once you are familiar with normal ones. So last tip is scan every patient for every possible anomalies. Things will be in your reflexes. So start developing reflexes. So that's all for today. These are all normal videos I showed you today, and will post videos of abnormal anomalies in FTS and 2-3 good lectures showing FTS in detail. So stay tuned for more and see you in next session at Sonomantra. So bye. Till then, thank you.